I'm Richard from Edelrid. Yeah, so the Jul 2 is basically a single cuber. It's based on the same concept as the Mega Jul that we showed last year. It's a brake-assisted cuber belay device that we can actually use it for thicker ropes. So it's especially made for beginners, for gym climbers, where you have thicker ropes, 10.5 millimeter ropes, old ropes, fuzzy ropes, where it's still working perfectly fine. Also, by reducing the braking strength on that one, what we can do is that we can actually make the fall a little bit more dynamic. The problem that you have with a Mega Jul, with a Gree, with the Edelrid, with all these devices, click up as well, is that the fall is really static. The belay just closes up. So what can happen if people don't know how to belay with the body is that you get a really hard fall and people just smash the wall. Also, we just slightly modified the geometry that it's easier to open up. So it's really easy to find the point where you can actually lower somebody off. For belaying, it's exactly the same as a Mega Jul. You can pay out the rope either by using it as a cuber or by lifting up the handle and paying out the rope like this. As soon as there is load on the rope, it's more or less blocking, but not entirely. So you can see that here it's sliding through the device. So what we want to do with that is actually, on the one side, we want to teach the user to not let go of the braking rope, because once you have a fully locking brake-assisted device, people tend to go like, oh yeah, I don't need to hold the rope. If you use a thinner rope, it's going to be more slippage or less braking force. If you use a thicker rope, it's going to be going to have more braking force. Same thing with the carabiner. The rounder a carabiner is, the less braking force it's going to have. So if you've got a really profiled carabiner, it's better. But still, it's going to work with every HMS carabiner more or less. What we highly recommend, of course, is to use a carabiner with a captive spring, that the carabiner doesn't twist in the belay loop. Construction-wise, we got a steel inner core, so there's no abrasion on the part. The handling is really intuitive. It's very easy, or very similar to just using a tuber. So it doesn't really matter which device you use. You can always switch between a tuber, between a Jul, between a Mega Jul. It's all the same handling-wise.